The term lupus refers to systemic lupus erythematosus. Nephritis refers to the nephron, the Greek word for kidney, and itis means inflammation. So lupus nephritis refers to inflammation of the kidney that results from having systemic lupus erythematosus. Lupus is an autoimmune disease in which the immune system attacks various parts of the body, including the skin, the joints, lungs, heart, central nervous system, and of course, the kidneys. In fact, about half of all individuals with lupus develop some form of lupus nephritis. In lupus, what happens is that some cells have their DNA so badly damaged that the cell undergoes programmed cell death, or apoptosis, and it dies. This produces all these little apoptotic bodies and exposes the insides of the cell, including parts of the nucleus, like DNA, histones, and other proteins, to the rest of the body. Now, with lupus, the immune system is more likely to think that the cellular parts are foreign, or antigens, and since they're from the nucleus, they're referred to as nuclear antigens, and immune cells try to attack them. Not only that, though, individuals with lupus have less effective clearance, essentially meaning they aren't as good at getting rid of these apoptotic bodies, and so they end up having more nuclear antigens floating around. So as a result of all this, B cells start producing antibodies against these pieces of nucleus, which are called anti-nuclear antibodies. These anti-nuclear antibodies bind to nuclear antigens, forming antigen-antibody complexes, which drift away in the blood and deposit in various places, including the kidneys. These immune complexes can then initiate an inflammatory reaction, which is known as a type 3 hypersensitivity reaction. Lupus nephritis is classified into various types, depending on the exact site of these immune complexes and subsequent inflammatory reaction. The most common site of deposition is just underneath the capillary wall, also known as the endothelium. But deposits can also be within the Bowman space of the nephron, the basement membrane, or near the mesangial cells. The extent of inflammation within the kidney can be focal, which involves nephrons in just one area, or diffuse, involving almost all the nephrons in both kidneys. In the majority of cases, lupus nephritis presents as a nephrotic syndrome, which means that the damage to the nephron allows plasma proteins to get into the urine, which causes proteinuria, typically greater than 3.5 grams per day. An important protein in the blood is albumin, and so when it starts leaving the blood, people get hypoalbuminemia, low albumin in the blood. With less protein in the blood, the oncotic pressure falls, which lowers the overall osmotic pressure, which drives water out of the blood vessels and into the tissues, called edema. Finally, it's thought that as a result of either losing albumin or losing some protein or proteins that inhibit the synthesis of lipids, or fats, you get increased levels of lipids in the blood, called hyperlipidemia. Just like the proteins, these lipids can also get into the urine, causing lipiduria. And those are the hallmarks of nephrotic syndrome: proteinuria, hypoalbuminemia, edema, hyperlipidemia, and lipiduria. In some cases, though, lupus nephritis can present as a nephritic syndrome, which means that the damage to the nephron ends up allowing red blood cells to filter into the urine, which causes hematuria, or blood in the urine. The location of lesions and the extent of kidney injury often predicts whether the general presentation will be nephrotic versus nephritic syndrome, but is far from exact. And this brings us to the diagnosis of lupus nephritis, which typically requires a kidney biopsy. Deposition of immune complexes in the Bowman space results in a characteristic crescent-shaped swelling of the area, and deposition in the basement membrane can cause thickening of the structure, giving rise to a wire loop pattern. It's also possible to look for the presence of immune markers like complement proteins and immunoglobulins in the glomerulus by staining them with fluorescent markers. Lupus nephritis is treated the same way that lupus is treated, by suppressing the immune system. This is often done with corticosteroids, as well as with specific medications like mycophenolate and cyclophosphamide. Alright, as a quick recap, lupus nephritis is inflammation of the kidneys caused by lupus, and it can present as either nephrotic or nephritic syndrome. It happens due to the deposition of immune complexes in the nephron, which is a type 3 hypersensitivity reaction, and the resulting inflammation causes damage that can be detected on a kidney biopsy.
Helping current and future clinicians focus, learn, retain, and thrive. Learn more.